just listening to for a preview was NOFX, Hepatitis Bathtub EP. Now, I remember when this actually came out, I bought it off at Records for $5. But when this came out, it was kind of controversial. What do you mean by that? Well, not controversial as that it offended people, but people were a little, I guess, disappointed and let down that it wasn't new content. In fact, it was just old stuff recorded in a basement in Omaha in 1987. As you can see, those songs are old as fuck. Too Mixed Up, Nothing But a Nightmare, Young, Drunk, and Stupid, No Problems, and Death of a Friend. Yeah, I remember reading a lot of reviews and how this record got negative feedback, whatever, because, you know, they were expecting something awesome. But one thing I will say is, if that is in fact Hefe, which I believe it is, Hefe wasn't even in the band during this period of time. He isn't even on. He isn't even in the credits here. But yet, he's right there. I mean, I know that's the book cover, but it's kind of funny. You know, you'd think if they're going to do, you know, a yesterday's type of a vinyl record, you know, you'd think they would maybe put a picture of the people who actually took place in the songs on them. Oi, so I wanted to add this to it real quickly. Since Hefe is on the cover, and since Hefe is in the book, and the book is about NOFX's entire story, their history, their present, their well, they're all that, you know, their stories, I really wish that NOFX would have also, with the songs that are already on it that were recorded in a basement in Omaha in 1987, I wish they would have also included some earlier demos with Hefe. Like, let's say, you know, maybe their first gig with them, or just some early shit that they did with El Hefe, because that would have made a lot more sense, since he's on the cover, and since he's definitely a part of the band's history. I mean, he's not just a part. Hefe is a major part of NOFX. So why not include some of his earlier shit on the Hepatitis Bathtub EP? Honestly, I have absolutely no problem with this record. In fact, I love it because it's hardcore, it's pure, it's fucking raw, it's NOFX back in the days when everyone else says they sucked and, you know, they were just... I see that in so many NOFX interviews and documentaries where fans are like, well, if you ever seen footage of them back then, oh god. Yeah, they were terrible back then, but today they can play good. In fact, I prefer my hardcore punk to be distorted and loud and obnoxious and just breaking shit and, oh shit, I got half the song wrong, oops, it's polished, it sounds good. The era this is from is definitely my favorite era, NOFX, and I know a lot of people are going to argue about that, but you know what? Opinions are opinions, and Hefe is the boss! And Fat Mike is fat, Eric Melvin plays the accordion, and Smelly, well, he just used to get his heroin in really, unique ways. I mean, what heroin junkie didn't get their heroin in really fucked up ways? It's heroin. I mean, I've never gotten it in any way, and I refuse to ever, but good band with an intensified backstory. Go read The Hepatitis Bathtub! Or go listen to it, because there's also an audio file of it. And Biafra's on it, too. He tells the stories of I don't remember which member it is, but one of the older members of NOFX who's no longer in the band, Jello Biafra, reads part of that story. But anyway, this is the NOFX Hepatitis Bathtub EP, 45 RPM. I think you can still buy it on Fat Rec. If not, go on eBay. I'm sure you'll be able to get it. And I highly recommend this to anyone who loves NOFX or who loves some old, raw, in-your-face, breaking instruments, hardcore punk shit from 1980s! Woohoo! Anyway, I'm Anarchic Cousin. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll have more coming out to you soon. And subscribe and dos vidania.